Good morning, everybody. Just in this morning to the morning, so hopefully it will be on before the morning is over. I'm a bit later today because I've been up to see my mum and indoor visits have started, so you have to go up an hour before your visit in order that you can get the COVID test, lateral flow test done before they'll allow you into the care home. So it's not that I'm late, I've been very busy already this morning. It's just that we didn't get organised before I went away up there earlier to get the message done. So here we are now, and hopefully once we've done this, I'll get my lunch because I'm now starving. So today is Tuesday, a bit dull, better than yesterday, I think. Tuesday 9th of March, and we have been reading from the Tear Fund, and today it's a message from Rachel Adams, and she works with the young people, I think, in Tear Fund. We've had her before. It doesn't give us, I think that's what I remember about Rachel Adams. Yep, she mentors youth and writes for Tear Fund. So her passage today is Isaiah chapter 24. So we'll read Isaiah chapter 4 before we have Rachel's thoughts for today. And her chapter is entitled, The Lord Will Punish the Earth. The Lord is going to devastate the earth and leave it desolate. He will twist the earth's surface and scatter its people. Everyone will meet the same fate, the priests and the people, slaves and masters, buyers and sellers, lenders and borrowers, rich and poor. The earth will lie shattered and ruined. The Lord has spoken, and it will be done. The earth dries up and withers. The whole world grows weak, both earth and sky decay. The people have defiled the earth by breaking God's laws and by violating the covenant he made to last forever. So God has produced a curse on the earth. Its people are paying for what they have done. Fewer and fewer remain alive. The grapevines wither and wine is becoming scarce. Everyone who was once happy is now sad, and the joyful music of their harps and drums has ceased. There is no more happy singing over wine. No one enjoys its taste anymore. In the city, everything is in chaos, and people lock themselves in their houses for safety. People shout in the streets because there is no more wine. Happiness is gone forever. It has been banished from the land. The city is in ruins, and its gates have been broken down. This is what will happen in every nation all over the world. It will be like the end of harvest when the olives have been beaten off every tree and the last grapes picked from the vines. Those who survive will sing for joy. Those in the west will tell how great the Lord is, and those in the east will praise him. The people who live along the sea will praise the Lord, the God of Israel. From the most distant parts of the world we will hear songs in praise of Israel, the righteous nation. But there is no hope for me. I am wasting away. Traitors continue to betray, and their treachery grows worse and worse. Listen to me, everyone. There are terrors, pits, and traps waiting for you. Anyone who tries to escape from the terror will fall in a pit, and anyone who escapes from the pit will be caught in a trap. Torrents of rain will pour from the sky, and earth's foundations will shake. The earth will crack and shatter and split open. The earth itself will stagger like a drunk, sway like a hut in a storm. The world is weighed down by its sins. It will collapse and never rise again. A time is coming when the Lord will punish the powers above and the rulers of the earth. God will crowd kings together like prisoners in a pit. He will shut them in prison until the time of their punishment comes. The moon will grow dark and the sun will no longer shine. For the Lord Almighty will be king. He will rule in Israel, he will rule in Jerusalem on Mount Zion, and the leaders of the people will see his glory. Amen. And God bless this reading from Isaiah chapter 24. And Rachel Adams has chosen as her verse, Isaiah chapter 4, verse 4. The earth dries up and withers. The world languishes and withers. The heavens language with the earth. And she says, last summer, I brought my garden back to life. With God within me and surrounding me, together we levelled the ground, planted new grass and a tree, and invited wildlife back in. In the loneliness of lockdown, I've never felt closer to God. In its entrapment, I've never felt more free. This is what happens when we align ourselves with God's plan. Among the brokenness, we can find peace and purpose. God asks us to take care of creation and our neighbours, an increasingly urgent call. Alongside the pandemic, we're in the midst of a climate crisis that is hitting people in poverty the hardest. They're facing more frequent and deadlier disasters. They're losing their food, their homes, and their hope. The climate crisis is a huge issue, but revival always starts small and starts within. It begins with persistent prayer. If we want to see movement on this issue, we have to pray, then roll up our sleeves and take part in restoring God's beautiful earth. And Rachel's prayer for today is, Creator God, I'm sorry for how I've treated your earth and ignored your plea to take care of creation. Show me how I can make amends and help restore your earth. Amen. So, take care today, everybody. Very quiet outside on the roads there. When I was out, I was surprised how quiet it was. So, obviously, still people are not moving, although where is there to go anyway? So, take care yourself, of yourself, everybody, and everyone round about you. And we will be back tomorrow. So, see you then. Bye.